In this week's video, we're looking at the coronavirus. You guys have sent me so many messages, so many comments, and even letters to do a video on this topic, and that I am going to do. I'm going to give you loads of information about coronavirus, its symptoms, how it's spread, how you can try and prevent it, and also the surgical masks. Do they really work? And loads more. This is going to be quite a long video, so what I am going to do is leave a breakdown in the description below with relevant timestamps so you can find the information that you require. So the coronaviruses are a large family of viruses which cause a range of illnesses that start from a common cold, which we've all pretty much had, all the way up to more serious ones such as SARS. Now this coronavirus is what we call a novel coronavirus. So it's a new strain that we've never actually seen in humans before. Coronaviruses are zoonotic. This means that they're transmitted between animals and humans. However, there are several coronaviruses that only infect animals. But if they do cross over, if they do infect humans, for example, the novel coronavirus we're dealing with right now, this is what we call a spillover event. Now before we continue, please remember that this is a developing situation and every day we're learning more about coronavirus. So all the information I give to you in this video is relevant and up to date on this date right now. But as we learn more, as the scientific community learn more, all of this information can potentially change. This video was filmed on the 1st of February 2020. All the information and data is from the WHO, NHS and Public Health England. However, this data can change with time as I've just explained. So what I will do is I'll leave some really useful links by the WHO and NHS all about coronaviruses. And these websites are constantly updated, so I'd highly recommend everyone checks them out. So what are the symptoms of coronavirus? Well, it can include any of the following: a fever, a runny nose, a dry cough, a sore throat, and then it can lead on to shortness of breath, and in some severe cases, patients will need hospital treatment. So how severe is it? Well, it really depends. At the moment, we know that 1 in 5 cases can become severe, leading to things like pneumonia or acute respiratory distress syndrome, leading to mechanical ventilation, and in some circumstances, it can even cause death. Now, we currently know that the novel coronavirus has a mortality rate of 2%. This means that 2% of people who have had the novel coronavirus have sadly died from it. But it also means that 98% of people who have had the novel coronavirus have got better from it, which is much less than, let's say, for example, SARS, that has a mortality rate of 10%, or even Ebola, which has a mortality rate of 70%. Now, it is important to remember, this is based on the current information that we have. There are currently people in hospital receiving treatment for the coronavirus, so the number could change and it's not an absolute certainty. Now, in terms of treatments, unfortunately, there is no treatment currently for the coronavirus. However, the symptoms can be treated, so each patient will be looked at individually. Depending on their symptoms, they will have different treatments for it. Also, another piece of good news is they are currently working on a vaccine for the coronavirus, which is great news. Currently, the risk of getting the illness in the UK is low, and the NHS guidance is that any travellers returning from Wuhan, China, or from the Hubei province in the last 14 days should stay at home, stay indoors, and avoid contact with other people. And please contact NHS 111 and make them aware of your recent travel. For those individuals, if you do get any symptoms of coronavirus that we spoke about earlier, such as a fever, a sore throat, shortness of breath, please avoid other people, stay indoors, and contact NHS 111 or your doctor's surgery for advice. Please don't walk in, just call them. This also applies to anyone returning from any part of China apart from Hong Kong and Macau. So if you get symptoms of coronavirus, please stay indoors, avoid other people, and call NHS 111 or your doctor's surgery. Please, once again, do not walk into your doctor's surgery. Please just call and get more information and advice. This is all to reduce the spread of the virus. And also remember, even if your symptoms are mild, please stay indoors and avoid spreading the virus. So this means staying at home for at least 14 days after arriving from Wuhan or the Hubei province, or if you have symptoms and you've come from any part of China, you need to stay at home for at least 14 days. And this means you're not gonna go to work, don't go to school, don't go to public places. And obviously if you need food, contact friends or family or delivery drivers to bring it to your house. Now this is the current guidance from the NHS. However, it can change tomorrow, it can change next week, it can change next month. So the best thing to do is to check the dedicated coronavirus website out that the NHS have made. It has all the up-to-date information. I'll leave a link in the description below, so please check it out. And also, please remember, if you have been in contact with someone who has had a confirmed case of the novel coronavirus, then please call and contact NHS 111 or your doctor. So how is coronavirus spread? Well, we don't know exactly how it's spread from person to person, but similar viruses spread through cough droplets, through close contact. Now, close contact is being close within 2 meters of someone who is infected for at least 15 minutes. But like I said, there's still lots of information that we don't know. So for example, how long does it take for the virus to spread? What is the true incubation period? So this is the period that you've got the virus, but you don't have any symptoms yet. It's thought to be 1 to 2 weeks, but we're not sure of this yet. And also, can the virus be spread when you're asymptomatic? Now, the WHO recommends standard prevention techniques to help reduce the spread. So tip number one is to wash your hands regularly throughout the day using soap and water. Wash it for at least 20 seconds. Now, if you haven't seen the NHS video on how to do this properly, it's a really good video. I'll leave a link in the description below. Please check it out. It's really useful. Also, please remember, if you don't have access to water or soap, you can always use an alcohol hand rub. Tip number two, avoid touching your face as much as you can, because our hands, they carry so many germs, and the way they get in is through your mucous membrane, so through your eyes, through your mouth, through your nose. That's the way that infections get in. So I know it's easy to do when you're not thinking and you're going to auto drive and you might touch your face, but please try and avoid touching your face as much as you can. Tip number three, cover your mouth and nose with a tissue when you cough or when you sneeze and throw it in the bin straight away. The virus can survive for about 15 minutes on the tissue, which is why it's so important you throw it in the bin straight away. On other surfaces, like door handles, for example, the viruses are unlikely to survive more than 24 hours. Tip number four, try to avoid close contact with anyone who's showing signs of a respiratory illness. So if they're coughing, if they're sneezing, try and avoid contact with them and try and maintain a gap of at least 2 meters from them, because this is the distance that's been shown a sneeze or a cough can travel. Tip number five, if you're not feeling well, stay at home. Even if it's something mild like the common cold, just stay at home and reduce the risk of spreading your virus to other people and keep your community safe. Tip number six, if you use a public workspace, let's say for example here, we all use different rooms all the time. So give it a quick wipe down the area that you're going to be using to work. It can make a significant difference. Also, moving on to tip number seven, when you're eating meats, when you're eating eggs, make sure you're cooking them thoroughly. Another question many people have asked me is about the surgical face masks and if they can help. Well, I do know that virologists are skeptical about their effectiveness against airborne viruses. But there is some evidence to show that they do help prevent hand to mouth transition, which we spoke about earlier with regards to mucous membranes. However, routine surgical masks for airborne viruses are not really effective. The reason being that they are quite loose fitting, they have no air filter, and also they leave your eyes exposed. So remember the mucous membranes we spoke about earlier? That's an exposed area that infections can get into. So the best advice I can give everyone is to maintain the hygiene tips that we spoke about earlier. I really hope you find this video about coronavirus useful. Please remember though, there is a lot of information that's false on social media about coronavirus. So please always use a reputable source of information for health knowledge, such as the NHS, Public Health England, WHO. I will leave links to all of these in the description below. And once again, please remember that this is a developing situation. Every day we're learning more about the coronavirus. So all the information given in this video is relevant and up to date on this date now. But as we learn more, as the scientific community learns more, the information could potentially change. This video was filmed on the 1st of February 2020. All the data and information was from the WHO, NHS and Public Health England. However, this data can change with time, as I've just explained. So what I will do is I'll leave some really useful links in the description below to the WHO and NHS pages all about coronaviruses. They update these pages constantly, so the best way to stay up to date is to check out those web pages. Always remember that you're awesome, and I'll see you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.